Hi, Cozy Reading Series. My name's Sophie, and I'm going to be reading a poem from my book, Brat, which came out with Gordon Hill Press in fall of 2022. After a one-night stand with myself, I ask myself to stay the night. I know she wants me by her side in sleep. I do not really ask her to stay, only imply she is invited. I speak our language. Now I understand why no one wants me to hickey them over the collar and on the wrist, all these visible marks of myself. Myself touches me as if she is an endangered species of jungle cat that craves everyone it sees. We kneel and braid each other's hair from the front, reach over shoulder, pull from the nape. Though we reflect one another, I am jealous of myself, the perfect way she uses her fingers. Myself can finish me so much faster than I can. She sees in me a target. I do not envy that all her kisses are anxious with farewell. Not everyone understands how to care for endangered predators, even knowing how much she needs. I want myself to post a photo of us together, though we only just met hours earlier at a bus station. In the blue of a rain-smeared window, she appeared. I wish myself would forgive me without my having to ask for sleeping with yet another friend who has broken the heart of someone I love. I do it all the time. We love to fuck heartbreakers because it makes us feel intact. We can look each other in the heartbreaking smile and not diminish. Yet I know that after myself leaves, I will fall asleep on only half the mattress. She will decide to leave, but first we go to bed again to prove that we are irresistible. Both of us are willing to wear the 8-inch purple cock to make it easier, but really, we would each rather be the princess of lollipops, purple tongues and purple thumbs and purple knees. We both hate self-pleasure because what? Do we not care about the nuclear holocaust and the famine in that other country? But we both love to watch it happen, so why the fuck do we get off? From the back, I see myself as if in a hairdresser's mirror, same dainty, broad body. The calves strain under oceanic tattoos, and the waist is perhaps the parabola of time. We breathe in spaces between I. Therefore, after, we twine each other like a lemon grove, as if to remain, but myself chooses cab fare from the dresser and kisses me on the hip-soft cheek. When my lower lip quivers, it means my mouth needs filling. We've been like this since forever. She puts her thumbs over my eyelids and swipes the tears away. Even she does not stay the night. Until the taxi leaves view, I hug the door frame in a borrowed shirt and hope she's going home to no one. Thank you so much.